spend a lot more time on the stock market, buying toilet paper shares and hand sanitizer stocks.
That's when it really started to kind of boom for Best. So I don't think we would do anything that much differently. We were touring with, just had a tour with Decapitated in the UK, and no, that was another year. We did a lot of touring, and then our record came out, and we were doing the biggest festival shows we ever did in Copenhagen and Roskilde here in Denmark. So you can check that out as well.
Well, I spent a lot of time in my flat during this time and in the studio, but maybe it could have been really nice to have a house on the countryside or something like that. Some place closer to the nature, kind of. That would have been nice. Instead of, like, it's weird when you're isolated in a city, because you're very close to a lot of people, but you can't, still you're really isolated, so that kind of sucks. It's better to be, if you're gonna be alone, you could be in a nice place, kind of. Yeah.
If I was able to go back 1 year before the pandemic, I'd probably get married sooner. My wife and I got married in Auckland in January 2020, and obviously we didn't know that the pandemic was brewing at that point, and didn't expect it to have the impact that it did. And actually, by the time we got the visa arranged and everything else, it was September before we saw each other again. So I flew home 2 days after we got married, and so we had to wait a long time before we saw each other, which was not the easiest of situations. And aside from that, I'd probably have bought some shares in Zoom.
Well, if I got to travel 1 year before the pandemic started, I think there will be a bunch of things that I would have done. But I think that I will try to, in the best way possible, to spread the message that we should take better care of the world and of the things we do, and to show a little bit more empathy towards everything.
Not a whole heck of a lot. I feel like I've been doing what I've been meant to do as far as my life goes, being able to live my dream and get out and play guitar and be a part of a great band like Whitesnake and be with Trans-Siberian Orchestra. And also tour with Cher recently. I mean, there really hasn't been much for me to complain about or do differently. I feel like I try to do the best I can at every turn, and none of us bat 1,000 with that. But honestly, I always have good intentions with this stuff and try and do the best I can and be grateful for it.
I'm pretty happy with the year before the pandemic started. We took with Epica first a year off, and then we did some shows. And right after, we started working on the new album, and that everything went very smooth. The shows were great. The working on the album was a very pleasant experience. So there's actually nothing that I would have done different, even with knowing what would have happened. I think that year would have not been so different from what it actually was.
We were recording.
Were we?
Yeah, we were okay. Recording Sermon. Oh. Started in February, right?
Yeah, I don't think I would do anything necessarily differently.
Nah.
Like, I wasn't an asshole before.
No.
And probably, hopefully, I'm not now. So hopefully that's, I don't know. Well, that's up to.
Get a load of this guy.
Yeah, I don't think I would do anything differently.
Nah,
just maybe,
neither.
Like, enjoy people's company.
There you go.
I don't, like, both of us don't drink, so it's not like, like we can't be like, I should have partied more.
Yeah, no.
I would do exactly the same.
I think so. I really think so.